Hey everybody, it's Phil with Behringer. How are you doing today? Welcome to Music Studios. I want to talk to you today about the UMC202HD and what to do with it right out of the box. So when you get the UMC202HD out of the box, one of the first things you're going to notice probably is that there's no power cord. That's because the UMC202HD is actually powered via USB connection. So simply take the USB cable that comes with it and connect it to the back of the unit and then connect it to a USB port on your computer. It's going to be that simple. You will notice when you connect it that the power light will come on and the 48 volt phantom power light will come on as well. And this allows you to use both dynamic and condenser microphones. So this is another super cool feature. Now when you get the unit, you always want to make sure that you have the latest drivers for it. On the PC end of town, there's going to be drivers here at Behringer.com. You go to the page for the UMC202HD, you go to downloads, and you're going to see the drivers for it are waiting for you to download and then install on your computer. On the Mac side of the house, the Mac is going to automatically see it as a USB audio device, so you can just connect it and go to town. So on the UMC202HD itself, it's a two input, two output device. So there's two quarter inch jacks on the back that you're going to say take to your speakers, and then there's a headphone jack on the front with a dedicated volume control for your monitoring with headphones. To get signals in and out, you have two inputs on combo jacks. So it's quarter inch and XLR capable. And this means that you can use, you know, quarter inch things for like a guitar output or a keyboard output, and you can use the XLRs for both dynamic mics, and because of the phantom power you can use condenser mics as well, studio grade condenser mics. It makes it really handy. Okay. On each channel you have a button for line or instrument, so you can select the level range of what you're actually recording, and an input gain knob for each channel. Okay, so that's going to be the same. Now you have a pad button as well, so if the level is coming in and it's kind of hot, no matter what you do with the level knob, you can hit the pad button, it's going to drop it down, and then you'll have gain control again. On the far right, like I said, you have a dedicated headphone jack and volume control for that, and then you have a button that says direct monitoring and an overall master volume. Now the direct monitoring is one of the cool things because it's going to get rid of latency in the system so that you can actually hear what you're recording in real time with no delays. It's a great feature. So that's as easy as it is to get the UMC202HD out of the box and connect it to your computer and get it all set up and good to go. In the next video, we're going to talk about actually recording audio with it, but I wanted to go over some of the cool features of the UMC202HD and how to get it originally dialed in. For more information and media, feel free to come visit us at Behringer.com. Thanks for joining us here at Music Studios.